What do we like about Christmas? Well, one of those answers might be having no guilt on consuming snacks and junk. Hence, all the diet adverts come out in January. Anyway, I advise you to watch all the way through this, as I have a treat if you grew up in the 90s, or if you like the 90s in general as a historical fascination. I will start with some 90s music and some 90s Christmas music. Fits in well with the time. Many of the snacks I will be talking about are actually snacks for all year round. They have just made their adverts more Christmassy, hence they have caught my eye, and I feel I can talk about them. So I will start with Walkers. Their adverts tend to feature former footballer and Match of the Day anchor Gary Lineker. However, the advertising management team have decided to go for a substitution, as off comes Lineker and onto the pitch, or into the arena, or onto the stage, which fits in well with the character I'm describing, Mariah Carey. The packets tie in with the advert, as you can buy packets of regular flavoured Walkers, which feature Mariah Carey, which also accompanies a present motif. So these packets look really nice, but I'm not here to talk about crisp packets, I'm here to talk about crisp adverts. Christmas adverts, anyone? This advert also advertises for limited festive flavours, such as Brussels sprouts and pigs in blankets. I haven't had them. I don't really think about buying Walker's crisps. After cutting the filming of a music video, Mariah talks about how great caring and sharing is at Christmas. But when Walker's crisps comes into the equation, sharing goes out of the window, as Walker's crisps are just too good to share, even at Christmas. Mariah then goes high-pitched to get everyone to cover their ears, including the elf getting in her way of her crisps. Thus, this plays at the advantage, as the elf lets go of the packet, meaning she can have full control over her snacks. Brilliant advert, and on some days, maybe my favourite. Well, obviously, my favourite fresh advert when it comes to advertising junk food. Secret Santa time for Cadbury, as they have used this advert to promote all of their products, including their advent calendars. Thus, chocolate would make an ideal present for whoever you need to buy your present for. In the past, Cadbury tend to advertise their products in separate adverts, hence you'd get a Heroes advert, a Rosie's advert, and a Dairy Milk advert, all separate alongside each other. But here, all their products are incorporated in one big advert. It's a reasonable advert, which is actually an advert from last year, but I have seen better Christmas adverts for Cadbury. You have to go back to 2015, incidentally, the year when Thunderbirds was rebooted by ITV. And here, the trucks make up an advent calendar with different numbers, which fits in brilliantly with the Thunderbirds aesthetic, and also that of Christmas. I just really like the way this advert is made up, and maybe recommissioning this advert will be okay for Cadbury's, as I do not expect Cadbury's to pit their wit against John Lewis. They don't need to outstage John Lewis, even though I probably would have said in 2015 that they did have a better advert than John Lewis, only because I liked it better. McDonald's again are reindeer ready and good to animals. The story is about a girl who wants to be a reindeer, and in the cartoon plays with a pet reindeer to fill the void left by her reluctant big sister. After running out of reindeer treats, or carrots, from McDonald's, they get into the car and the dad gets the girl more of the carrots. But then she says, how about Archie, who is actually a dog who is wearing antlers. After this, the big sister finally wants to play reindeers with everyone, only to get some McNuggets. You selfish! It's a shame that McDonald's seems to get overlooked in this John Lewis dominated landscape, or maybe landscape where other adverts tend to get more looking than McDonald's. as over the years there have been some good adverts about McDonald's. And this also shows that McDonald's is for everyone, hence they have a slogan, "There is a McDonald's for everyone." This is whether you are grown up, veggie, vegan, or even a reindeer, or actually, in this case, a dog. Just as long as you don't give them a Cadbury McFlurry, because dogs can't eat chocolate. Now to an advert I do not like, and for something full of fat. However, with healthy alternatives, which are not really that healthy, as at least at McD's you can get some carrots. This one is for the lower in sugar and bad stuff, yet it is pretty much still bad stuff, and that being Pepsi Max, from Virgin Cola, but not Virgin Cola, but actually Pepsi. I do not associate the beach with Christmas. And despite the use of jingle bells, the visuals do not make for a Christmassy advert. Even though many adverts these days have songs which are non-Christmassy, the aesthetic is very festive indeed. But I just can't say this about Pepsi, even though it seems to be dark and possibly set in winter. If you really want to hurl one back at Coca-Cola, do something better than this, as even the most rebellious people at Christmas, who might like rock or alternative music, would probably do normal things at Christmas which fit in with the time of the year. And that is definitely not surfing. Seriously, would you really want to go surfing at Christmas? Would you really want to go all the way to Ross Niagara and just risk your health? It's probably not safe. Even in summer, it's not even ideal to go surfing, especially in Ross Niagara. Why risk deliberately trying to freeze yourselves or get hypothermia? Whatever, just doesn't make sense. Never liked this advert, never have done, never probably will do. Pepsi though is usually a drink you have when the other one is not available. And this is a drink which is so significant with Christmas, it's actually affected the appearance of Mr. Claus. Christmas has just not been Christmas since the mid-90s without the Coca-Cola trucks, which have been altered, updated, or even taken on with a different spin. Sadly, in 2006, we didn't see this advert. Instead, we got a social history advert about Santa, Christmas, and Coca-Cola, which replaced the trucks outright that year, meaning that we saw no trucks riding across the countryside at all in 2006. And for this reason, I did not like the 2006 advert, only because I missed the trucks. But at least they have been present again ever since. This year, the edit is very close to the original 90s variant. So much, it has the Always Coca-Cola slogan at the end. But at the end, it tells us that we should recycle, which is as modern as it gets, with the whole environmental message. This is my favourite Christmas advert of all time. Not by logic, but only as this is the earliest memory of Christmas adverts that I have. And for me, Christmas is not Christmas without this. I find this advert very reassuring and comforting for me to see this gem in this day and age, whatever happens in the world today. And tune! Some things might have left us, but at least we have the Coca-Cola trucks. And I am Tim Goodwin, over and out, wishing you to take care this Christmas and for peace in the new year. And I can finally say, it is the right time of year. Holidays have pretty much come. Holidays are coming. Tis the season. Watch out. Look around.